soil, just the occasional beard net if you get too close to the merchandise.
I'm wearing this because we don't want any mustache hair in the kale.
Yes, it's just an extra precaution to make sure there's reduced risk of food contamination. If I didn't shave for 24 hours, I would wear a beard net as well.
But if some of the concerns seem trivial, the overall purpose of addressing a world food crisis is obviously not. And AeroFarm's co-founder David Rosenberg warns...
The food crisis is already here. Some people attribute the Arab Spring and the catalyst of that to a sharp increase in the price of wheat.
How much of a contribution to the solution is farming like yours?
It definitely has a place. Whether it's 5%, 10%, 50%, it's hard to say. It depends how fast it's adopted.
Rosenberg intends that to be as fast as possible. And he sparked interest from investors the world over, including China's immense sovereign wealth fund and one of Britain's most prominent investment trusts, both touring AeroFarms the day we were there.
And so those folks are thinking about investing in or are going to invest in what you're doing here and abroad?
Correct.
So are there going to be facilities like this in China? Are there already?
Eventually, the vision is to build these farms all over China.
And what's the key to the technology? At AeroFarm's R&D facility, a former disco, marketing director Mark Oshima explained.
AeroFarms, aero meaning growing with aeroponics, we're misting the roots with nutrients. It's much more efficient than hydroponics, much more effective in terms of delivering the nutrients and less water.
So the little roots are like hanging in air as opposed to in the soil.
What makes us unique is our growing medium. We actually have a patent around our growing medium, which is cloth.
And the cloth is made of what?
Our proprietary growing cloth is made out of 100% recycled plastic. Each one of our growing cloths is made out of 26 water bottles that we're taking out of the waste stream.
And this is what's known as vertical farming, or verticulture.
When we think about vertical farming, we think about how many vertical beds of growing can we get in any kind of space. It's about that productivity per square foot. We're growing a wide range of different leafy greens. In red komatsuna, we have the green arugula, we have pak choi, we have ruby streaks mustard greens.
So you just...
enjoy it. That's one of the great things ready to eat here.
Yeah, kind of mustardy. And the arugula? This isn't your own proprietary arugula, is it?
It's our own proprietary growing algorithm, our recipe of dialing in on that flavor.
And speaking of growing, like AeroFarms, Gotham Greens is as well. It's now running two other urban farms in New York, including a brand new rooftop greenhouse in Queens, three times the size of the one above Whole Foods. And they'll soon be opening a rooftop in Chicago.
But there's a limit to how big you could be, right? I mean, you can't become the next Cargill or General Mills or something, right?
Perhaps one day. The sky is the limit when it comes to agriculture.
But hold on, says agricultural economist Jerry Nelson. There is a global food crisis in the making, he thinks. But as things stand, the world won't be fed by hydroponics alone.
And you're going to have some expenses that you don't have when you're growing, vegetables in the countryside. You want to go to grow lights, then, you know, you've got big expenses for electricity. You've got to have clean water. And you know, if you're talking about doing this in Delhi or Nairobi, the question is, where are you going to get the right amount of clean water?
So no, indoor farming may not be the answer to the world's food needs, but it's doing good and growing business in urban America. This is economics correspondent Paul Solman, now trying to eat all the local leafy greens I can find when not reporting for the PBS NewsHour.
Updating our top story tonight, police in Roseburg, Oregon, began searching for a motive after a mass shooting at a community college. The state attorney general said 13 people were killed, including the 20-year-old gunman. President